Now that we have all the foundational understanding of what's new in terms of clipping properties in Rhino 8, let's talk about workflows. So now we go to the other section, which is sections of views in the 3D ports, the 3D viewports and 2D details in page 7. So file, open. And that's exercise 5. And what I did here, I created a simple model that basically the layers, if you look at them, they are divided by object types so that we can see that we can actually cut it through NURBS objects, blocks, extrusions, meshes, and sub-Ds. And that's a nice kind of test model to like see all the possibilities, right? So let's just create a clipping section. So clipping section. Again, another way to create that is to go to the drafting under sections. The first one is a create. And let's put enter to cut it through all objects, and let's set it to be along the Y direction. So the direction is along the Y. All right. And now we can pick somewhere in the middle of that front kind of. I don't know. Am I snapping to anything here? Let's see. Mid. Yes, there is a snap. So I don't know. I'm not snapping to anything. Oh, here. That's better. I mean, I started to see something. It's not snapping it through a lot of things here. Vertex, not maybe. All right. So I snapped to the middle of that column. Press enter. And this has already set up some section styles, as you can see. The custom section style is through the NURBS object, and this is why I can see that showing right through, right? So this is already placed, and you can see that I can like move it, and it moves it through the object and show how the cut looks like. If I open the named view, I see that this view has been already saved as well, because when we run the command, we set the option to set named view to be yes. If that wasn't set to yes, and we don't have any view that is saved, it's really handy to have one to be saved. Again, the way to do that under drafting, sections, save views, and I select my section, and in this case, I will set the C plane as well. What that helps me is when I set that to view, I can draw exactly on the plane of the section. If I want to draw a rectangle that frame my section or anything, it would be handy to have the C plane set up to be yes. And I want the view to be clipped, and I want the projection to be parallel, and I press enter. And now you see that this view has been already created, right? Now, we already done that, but just as a review, if I want to load that view into my right view, for example, or any view I want, I just drag and drop that view. And the other way to do it is to go under the view itself and set a view and select A0. And as you can see, this view is now set there. So if I draw a rectangle, for example, around my view and go to the perspective, you can see that that rectangle was drawn in the section plane, because that particular view, A00, was set so that its construction plane is aligned with the section plane. All right. So if we want to also see that section in layout, we can create a page here and create a detail. And at that point, we already have put a plus here. You can have a new layout, but in that file that I gave you, it already has a page one created. So you just click on the tab here down the bottom. I don't know if you can see it. Down the bottom, perspective, top, front, A00, and page one. So if you click on page one, it takes you to that page. If you want to create a new page or new layout, you can do plus, new layout. And then it takes you to create page two. And we can create a new page in that case. This is called a layout view or a paper view. What you can is to create a detail like I did, you know, let me just delete that and I will recreate. So under page one, just say add detail. And by default, it just adds the top view. If you double click inside that square, it actually acts almost, you can think of it as a viewport in Rhino. And but it has a lot of additional features to help you set a scale and all good stuff. But for now, all I'm going to do is set that view like we did with the viewport to A00. And look what we have here. We have that layout, you know, that section of view set up on paper space, right? And another nifty thing is we might not want to show that widget of the section itself in layout. We want to see it only in modeling a space when we're controlling it. You can just go to the layers and you see how there is on, which is on and off, turning a layer on and off globally, like everywhere in model and layout space. But if I want to turn off the layers of the sections in detail only, then I can just turn it off there. Okay. And remember, the rectangle was drawn in that particular layer, that this is why it's turned off. So I can turn it off there, double click outside, I can see only the section. If I go back to my perspective, that layer is still on, right, in modeling space, but it is not in layout space, which is very, very nice. You needed to double click inside it first. When you are outside and you turn off, it turns off everything. But if you double click inside the detail that it's white, you see how it is? Like now I can pan it around, right? And there I set it to a certain kind of scale or whatever. I'm happy with it. Now in there, I can turn on and off the sections layer on the right. If you look at the layers, there is a column on, but there is a column detail on. That means I wanted to be turned off that layer in detail only. And this is when I kind of click on the light bulb that has corners, and my section lines disappear.
Okay.
You have to kind of drag the top, the title, to start seeing those. If it is too small, it disappears. So this is how it is. And then click outside and you'll see that in there and perspective, this is what we have. The nice thing there, in if we go back to the model itself, if we want to show only the section, you know, the slice, if you will. Remember, if we set the depth to zero of the section, it only shows the section itself. So let me double click and turn on the section here. So I work here. And if I click on the section and go in there and activate the depth to zero and click outside, as you can see that all I'm seeing is a slice through my model, but this is visual only. Keep that in mind. The only issue is that this thickness has been applied to layout as well as modeling space. So if you go to my model, all I see is that slice, which is in many cases is the desired thing to do, right? Is to see only that section, but sometimes it's not. So you can always, you know, have it not active, the depth in that, you know, you don't cut it through the perspective, so you see the whole model, right? But when you go to your page, you still only see this, and I'm going to turn off the sections part. And all you see is the section itself, which is very, very neat. Sometimes this is what you want to see, is to see some, you know, to see the section only. And that's one way to do it. And although this is only view, so it's a raster image, now if you go and want to print it, there is an option to have an output type. The raster is just an image like it is. At the point of exporting that section to print it, it actually gonna turn it into a vector drawing. So you can have the vector output here as an option. It's very interesting. One way to get an output out of Rhino, not inside Rhino at that point, outside Rhino, that is a vector output. Okay, and you can press a print, and that will get you a vector output of that section. That is one workflow. That is one workflow to be able to see sections or extract them. You know, if we go to perspective and we rotate our section a bit, you know, and move it in that direction, I'll activate it here so that I can see it as well. And you can see that the section has changed here. You go back to your page, and you will see that that section has been updated as well. To be sure that you got the angle that you are after, you can set the view to A2 again and be able to set it to whatever scale or anything that you're working with, and this is your section rotated and instantly available. So page, and then you go and say print, and under output type, there is vector output and there is raster output. And it's interesting, the vector output is actually adding the background here, but I don't know if you actually print it, it's going to look like that, but that's for PDF. But if you want to, what other format that we can export as a vector output? So you have this in the handout as well, in case you don't have to remember. This is exactly what it is. All right, number 5, right there.